Now, how much of you is in this? I mean, in terms of the script, because I know there was the original script
Yeah.
that was set in Victorian ages, and
Yeah.
now it's kind of been
Yeah.
modernized.
It was scary. Stephen's script was scary, and he's a great good writer of a great writer of that genre. It wasn't really about anything else though, and he won't mind me saying this, but for me it was I wanted to do more than just create a world where or have a world where ghosts exist and now we're going to escape with them, but actually to root it in this idea of why we see them and loss and grief, and I think that to create something that is a tangible, cohesive psychological journey, an emotional journey for our central character that goes through a supernatural world and is told through a supernatural prism. We see viewed through a supernatural prism rather than the other way around. And that was quite important. Because I didn't know when you're directing something, you've got to be able to hang your hook on it. You've got to know what it is you're after. And there needs to be a central, simple one-liner at the middle of any creative project really, before however complicated what you build around it. And once I settled on this idea that what I could write is you know, there's this idea that we see ghosts because we need to, then I thought, right, now I know it could be something. So that's what sort of got me much more on board with it.
You watch a lot of horror movies, especially American kind of genre horror movies, and they have their own cliches, their own beats. You know when things are going to come, da 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 da,
Yeah.
boom, there's the shock
Yeah.
for you. With this, I felt like it was a lot like a period drama that happened to, on occasion,
Yeah.
pull your heart out of your
Yeah.
chest.
Yeah.
Was that one of your, you say it was a hook to hat, you
Yeah,
had to?
that's it, the it being a period drama that has that supernatural element after it is a good way of putting it. When you're doing a genre piece, however, you've got to honor the tropes. I didn't you can be too unoriginal. You can have I compare it to taffeta, where there's two colored threads making this rather interesting fabric, and yes, one of the threads needs to be a complete originality. Novel ways of doing it. I think there's plenty in that. I think you never really settle on where knowing where you are. Just when you think a scene is about something, it's something else happens. Somebody is slapped, something comes out of nowhere, kids run out in front of a car. There's plenty of sort of never knowing where you are, and the delivery of it is novel. But you do have to cross weave that with the tropes and traditions of the genre. You can't just abandon them and say, well, we're going to be completely novel. No one's ever done this before. Well, it's not. It stops being a genre piece, really. And I'm not ashamed of being in that genre. But if you only use this, then I think you're into what you're talking about, which is, yeah, I kind of saw that coming. You know, you warned me it was coming and boo. And also, cheating. There's plenty of that genre that cheat. A bird flies out in the woods without any reason to. You know, and you're just cheating me. I just feel resentful then. You know, and that's true of psychological cheating, it's true of emotional cheating, it's true of everything, but certainly true in this genre of the bird flying out in the woods. We wanted to marry something together cohesively. It's complicated. You go back and look at it, watch it again. You can test it; it works. You know, the turning on the head, it does bear up when you post-analyze the film, and I think that's all part of that success of it, really.
With a lot of these horror cliches and what you expect from the genre is music.
Yeah.
The more I study or re-watch and watch certain horror movies,
Yeah.
sometimes you're scared, in part because of what you're seeing, but almost always you're prepared with sound.
Yes, you are, and it's a type of preparation. There's a few times you can get away with it without any sound, and that in itself becomes something you have done to the sound in deliberately not having it. There's a moment in this film which is proving very effective for people, but in which a child passes through frame, but there is no sound signature to it, and I think that's more effective for it. When you're doing a cue around a moment of scare or jump, what we found in the edit is if we completely misled and said that nothing's going to happen, it's fine, it's really boo, then it wasn't very effective because you're not on tenterhooks. You need that balance. And I think one of the score can help you with that. And Daniel wrote some incredibly sophisticated cues for this that yes, they ostensibly appear to be about the sentiment of what Florence is feeling, but there is still this tension underneath it. So when moments come out of that abiding background tension, you're ready to jump in a way you're not. So I've learned a lot that way. And I think that's something we all know the score is very important in this film. Absolutely right, but it's interesting to uncover why it is and how it is, rather than just that it is. I mean, I rank that alongside, you know, don't believe what people say in Hollywood as you know, not well-meaning but obvious advice, you know.
It is incredible how you've managed to get a cast like this for The Awakening. And also blood. It is. I don't know what you've got.
But no, you know, I'm a drug dealer. Yeah, that's no, I don't know why they came. I didn't really, I was aware of it at the time. There's a lot of naivety when you're doing your first film. I didn't really sort of think, oh my God, I'll never get this cast because I'm only a first time director. So I went along to the meetings thinking, well, they're actors. They want to work, you know, all that sort of stuff. They didn't just turn up either, these guys. A huge amount of trust, and that's something. And it means an awful lot when you're being trusted by people like Romelda and with that much experience, and Rebecca and Dominic, and we had a really good time. I think the film world needs to just be very careful before it grumbles too much. I know things can be tricky and financing is very hard and everything, but we're not digging coal dust for 11 hours a day and teaching difficult kids. You know, it's not a real job. It's a gift, and we shouldn't.
Tell me about it.
Yeah, you know what I mean.